Hello friends, this is Mr. P.S. Bidkar, Assistant Professor at Sanjay Godath University, Kolhapur. Today we are going to see about the inverter. Basically, inverter is a circuit which converts DC power into AC power. So today we are going to see about single phase full bridge inverter. So you can see, in case of inverter, if I am going for either single phase or three phase, the input is only DC power that we have at the input side, and output side you may have a single phase output or three phase output. So this is the circuitry where we are having or we are getting single phase output. So load is connected in between two arms. So this is arm number one and this is arm number two, between points A and B. Initially, if I want to get the output frequency equal to F, then you have to turn on the two devices or two IGBTs, that is B1 and B2, simultaneously. So you can see this in the next circuit. So to get a positive half cycle or to get point A positive, you have to turn on IGBT B1 and IGBT B2 simultaneously. So when these devices will turn on, they will work as a short circuit. So current flows from a positive terminal of a battery through B1 at point A, and from point A through load to point B through B2 and back to negative plate. So current flows from A to B and point A is positive. So this can be seen in waveforms also. Simultaneously we will draw the waveforms. So you can see, this is my switching pattern for B1 and B2. So in that case, I am giving gate 1 and gate 2, that is gate of IGBT1 and gate of IGBT2, a firing pulse, and during that I am getting output equal to plus Vs. So point A is reference point, and we say that if A is positive, we are getting voltage positive. So this will we will keep this on for time equal to T/2, or we will call it as a T1, time T1. Now once again move towards the circuit. So after time T1 or after time T/2, we are going to turn off both devices, IGBT B1 and IGBT B2, and we are going to turn on the another devices or remaining devices that we have in the circuit, IGBT B3 and B4. So we are going to turn on the B3 and B4. In that case, what happens? Current flows from, once again, same positive plate of a battery or supply through B3 to point B, and from point B to point A through load and through B4 and back to negative. So in this case, you can easily see that current flows from point B to point A. So direction of current is reverse. Also, you can see the negative plate of a battery is connected to point A. So now in this case, A is negative. So once again, we will go for previous circuit. So in this case, current flows from point A to B, and in second, current flows from B to A. Now in first case, A is positive, and second case, A is negative. You can see, so clearly this can be seen. So that what we can say is, we are getting positive half cycle of the output during B1 and B2 turn on, and we get negative half cycle at the output during B3 and B4 turn on. So same can be drawn in the waveform. So once again, this is the pattern of gate pulses for B3 and B4, that is IG3 and IG4. And when they are on, when B3 and B4 are on, we are getting negative half cycle at the output. So we'll say that for T/2, B1, B2 on, we are getting positive up cycle, and for next T by 2 we are getting negative up cycle. So if we add T by 2, we get output as a T. So simply, in simple words, we can write the formula. If the output frequency F can be calculated as 1 upon T. So where F is output frequency, T is T1 plus T2. T1 is nothing but on time of B1 and B2, and T2 is nothing but on time of B3 and B4. So you can see, once again we will go to this waveform, and clearly anyone can set the desired output frequency by going the reverse way. If you want to get a frequency like 50 hertz, so the time t is equal to 1 upon f, that is nothing but 20 milliseconds, and t1 is equal to 10 milliseconds, and next t2 is equal to 10 milliseconds. So you have to turn on b1 b2 for first 10 milliseconds, and you have to turn on b3 and b4 for next 10 milliseconds. So this will give you output frequency equal to 50 hertz. So like this you can get the desired frequency at the output in case of single phase full bridge inverter. So like this circuit works. So this is positive half cycle, this is negative half cycle. These are the waveforms, and this is the output frequency formula. Thank you.